Meanwhile, one of the framers of the 1987 Philippine Constitution rejects the idea that the charter is the root of the country's current problems. Attorney Christian Monsod spoke before a Senate panel that opened discussions on amending the Constitution. Monsod says blaming the country's problems on the Constitution is illogical.
We have largely failed in human development. I would argue instead that we have largely failed in human development, not because of the Constitution, but because we have not fully implemented it, especially its provisions on social justice and human rights and local autonomy. The Constitution is not the problem. It is part of the solution.
Monsod also rejected suggestions that constitutional amendments would ease restrictions on foreign ownership of businesses. He pointed out Congress has managed to pass laws to liberalize retail trade and public services. But Monsod clarified he is not completely against any charter amendments. He has expressed support for an amendment that would provide for block voting for presidents and vice presidents.
Philippine online news outlet Bulatlat.com files a petition to cite the country's telecoms regulator for indirect contempt. Bulatlat cites the refusal of the National Telecommunications Commission to comply with a court order to unblock its website. It says the website remains inaccessible to subscribers despite a writ of preliminary injunction served to the NTC on August 18th. The NTC blocked Bulatlat's website at the request of then-National Security Advisor Hermógenes Esperon, who alleged it had links to terrorist organizations.
Philippine government's purchase of allegedly overpriced laptops front and center at the Senate Blue Ribbon Probe Thursday. Senators grilled former education and budget officials over the 2.4 billion peso project flagged by the commission and audit in its 2021 report. There were heated exchanges as officials denied their involvement in the procurement.
Hindi ko sinabing ako nag-approve. Ang sinabi namin, nagbigay ang PSDBM ng action slip na
yes.
Kinongkor ng ICTS.
Nahawa ko yung dokumento. A certain Abram Abanil na nandiyan sa harap. Pakita siya yung kamay mo. Kailangan dalawa nag-approvehan ito.
Hindi, Your Honor. Wala akong pangalan dyan, Your Honor.
May papeles tayo rito.
Wala akong pangalan dyan, Your Honor.
Pagpataasan ang boses mo.
Yes,
kaya
Your Honor.
Kaya tayo may microphone dito. You don't have the right to elevate the modulation of your voice. Naririnig ka namin. Huwag mo kaming sigawan.
Also present during the hearing, Lloyd Christopher Lau, the former head of the Budget Department's procurement service, which was also embroiled in the farming controversy at the height of the pandemic. He offered a possible reason why units supposedly budgeted at 35,000 pesos each were purchased at a higher price. But Senator Alan Peter Cayetano, however, was not buying Lau's explanation.
Although there's disparity in the technical specification, there are also add-ons in the requirement of DepEd, yung warranty, mga servicing software. I'm not familiar with that. So I think that's the reason why when they conducted it, medyo ang alam ko tumaas kasi on 2020 and 2021, naubos po ang laptop ng PSDBM because all agencies were requesting for laptop. Also, in the market, nagkaubusan ng laptop.
I'm very sure it's honest corruption.
Between the two agencies.
Meron collusion dito kasi nga pareho naman may IT background, pareho naman may IT expertise. Eh, bakit pumayag?
Despite this controversy, Cayetano believes the PSDBM should not be abolished, as other lawmakers have called for, but he says those responsible for problematic purchases should be made accountable.
Former Education Secretary Leonor Briones, also present in the Senate probe, she defended her former agency's move to tap the PSDBM for the procurement of the laptops. Briones emphasized DepEd had its hands full at that time due to the pandemic and needed help in purchasing the laptops that were supposed to be used for online classes. Senate Blue Ribbon Chairman Francis Tolentino believes Briones was unaware of any possible irregularity in the contract.
Sa ngayon, sa nakikita ko na medyo naawa tayo sa matanda, parang wala. Sa akin lang yan, ha? Hindi to konklusyon ng committee. Kasi nga, yung umpisa pa lang, sinabi ko parang naikutan kayo ng inyong mga abogado.
Tolentino says the next stage of the probe on the laptop's purchase would call on the joint venture suppliers and other suppliers who failed to secure the bid.